I'm Alistair Johnson from Mount Boothby Pastoral Company, Tintinara. We are mixed farmers of sheep, cattle and cropping, but cropping mainly to feed these animals here, which is the pigs. There is probably currently 280,000 sows in the Australian pig herd, and that would probably equate to about 4.8 million pigs sold annually in Australia. You normally measure a size of a piggery by how many sows they have, and we are running currently about 700 to 750 sows, which probably puts anywhere in the vicinity of 5,500 to 6,000 growers on site at any time. We are 100% artificial insemination. Gestation cycle of a pig is 114 days, or an easy way to remember it as a school kid is 3 months, 3 weeks, and 3 days. We would like to think that we are probably averaging about 11 weaned per sow, or 10.8 to be exact, our farm is. On average, it's probably they're either on mum for 3 weeks or 4 weeks. These piglets here were actually on mum for 4 weeks. At the moment, these would be probably in the vicinity of 7 to 10 kilos. They are probably second to poultry in terms of feed conversion. So they would actually put on something like 700 grams a day, the pigs here. We have all of our pigs on this property growing in a straw-based igloo, is why the shape of the igloo is where the name comes from. There's no power to this site, so they can feed, and even in small wind gusts, it can create its own tunnel ventilation. We actually blow the feed up with a truck into those silos you can see down the end, and then I think you can even see that the piglets are actually eating by just gravity, and as they eat, the grain falls down. So really, they can look after themselves. We don't actually have to feed these pigs every morning or night. They are actually fed what they call ad lib, which means they have food whenever they want, but they will actually sleep most of the night and eat and rest during the day. We actually grow all our own grain on the farm, and that is a mixture of wheat, barley and lupins, which is the legume. Some people can use peas as well, but then we have to add additives like meat meal, blood meal, bone meal, fish meal, and actually vitamins and minerals, soybean meal. If you actually mixed what we feed the pig with milk, you could probably eat it for breakfast in the morning and live on it yourself, because pigs are exactly the same inside as humans. They might spend anywhere in the vicinity of 10 to 12 weeks in this shed, and then they will move up into a bigger shed, still staying in the same group. So 12 weeks here, and then probably 10 to 12 weeks up there until they are probably 100 kilo live weight. And that is when they would go to market as what we would call a bacon a pig. When an animal is slaughtered for human consumption, a lot of the animal is waste or offal. Well, in a sheep and a cow, you actually lose 50% of the animal to offal. With a pig, there's actually 75% of the animal which you can use then for human consumption. So that and their good feed conversion makes them a very good animal for food production in terms of using grain to make human food. We have different markets for different animals. Some are into wholesale markets into cities. Some are into the retail chains, being the big supermarkets. We are very lucky, and in terms of having a clean green image, we don't have a lot of the bad pig diseases that they have in other countries, especially in Europe and North America. That is the biggest reason why fresh pork cannot be brought into this country, because there is a risk of bringing those diseases in with that fresh meat. So most of these animals will end up on the fresh meat market.